I am recording this video with a minute and 20 left in the game, and the Miami Heat are up by 14. And I knew just for a fact that it was time to record this video because I've seen this movie multiple times just in this series alone. I've seen it multiple times. The Celtics are down by 12, 14 with 2 to 3 minutes left, and they make this heroic run. Right? And then at the end of the game, we rely on controversial calls, controversial referee calls to somehow justify us winning this game. And then Celtics fans are going to go on Twitter and say, oh, we were robbed because the refs were ass. No, we were not robbed. We were not robbed. I don't even know what the hell happened in this last minute of the game because I'm recording this video, but we did not get robbed. We should have played better for this whole game. We wouldn't have been in position to be in those controversial calls if we just played better the whole entire game. And I know I'm coming in this video with a lot of energy, a lot of anger, but I've been sitting on this video. I've been sitting on this video because this Celtics team, specifically this series, has gotten on my nerves so much in so many different ways, because this is a series that when we went into it, we were favored, right? The biggest threats to us making the finals were the Bucks and the Raptors. We got through the Raptors in the second round, and we didn't have to face the Bucks because the Miami Heat beat them. And we thought that the only reason the Miami Heat beat the Bucks, I didn't think this, but a lot of people thought that the only reason the Miami Heat beat the Bucks was because they were a better matchup. That didn't necessarily mean that they were the better team. Well, spoiler alert, the Miami Heat are an amazing team, and they proved it not just in this series, but in the last series. My apologies in advance if there's not a lot of editing in this video, because I want a raw reaction. I want to get this out as soon as possible, and I'm sorry in advance for that. And I want to apologize in this sense, because in the Clippers video, I didn't give the Denver Nuggets any credit. I want to do that for this series. Shout out to the Miami Heat for outplaying the Boston Celtics. They were the better team this series. They were the better team, and congratulations for making the NBA Finals. Y'all deserved it to make it to the NBA Finals more than the Boston Celtics, period, point blank. Because in this series, there were so many leads blown by the Boston Celtics. It was insane. This was a winnable series, and they flat out choked. We were the Clippers who choked those 15-point leads without the 3-1 lead in the first place, which I don't know if that's worse or not. I don't know. It's either we're choking these big-ass leads or coming back from a big-ass lead in the last 2 minutes of the game when we could have just played better the whole entire game. Game 1 had a 14-point lead with 11 minutes left in the game. Blew it. Game 2 had a 15-point lead with 9 minutes left in the third quarter. Blew it. Game 3, yes, we won, but mind you, we had a 20-point lead in the fourth quarter, and the Miami Heat were still able to get it down within 5. And in Game 4, the Miami Heat had the lead for the game for 43 minutes of the game, and we were trying to come back from 9 points with a minute left, and now we're relying on these controversial calls. Oh, it was a close game. No. No, we don't deserve that win. We don't deserve that win. Game 5, cool. You guys outplayed the Miami Heat that game. Now, Game 6 just happened tonight. And again, the Miami Heat outcoached us. It looked like they wanted it more than the Boston Celtics. It looked like they did. There's just so much shit I want to cover in this video. Number 1, Gordon Hayward. Oh my God. Gordon Hayward. I said this in my last video. I understand that it's not Gordon Hayward's fault, right? He didn't ask to be injured this amount of times. But it is so frustrating as a Celtics fan that your whole tenure as a Boston Celtics, aside from the first 60 games of this season, the first 50 games of this season, is that you've either been injured or playing trash because you're recovering from an injury. And then Brad Stevens wants to play you just because we're paying you $27, $30 million a year, and it just looks stupid for you to be on the bench, even though, if we're being honest, if we're keeping it a buck, if we're keeping it a bean, this whole time, ever since that injury, Gordon Hayward was better suited as a bench player than he was as a starter, and that's just a fact. Kemba Walker, I'm not even going to compare you to Kyrie, but in the second and third round, you were so disappointing. It's insane. Because going into this year, you were regarded as the best player on the Boston Celtics going into the year. And then as the year progressed, Jason Tatum took that realm and you were the second best player on the team. And then going into the playoffs, that slowly dwindled down to, okay, it's Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown's team and Kemba Walker, you're the third option. But then as we got deeper into the playoffs, not only was Jason Tatum better, not only was Jaylen Brown better, but Marcus Smart was also better. Not just even offensively, but defensively speaking as well. Just look at it. I don't even want to bring up the stats, but just look at his stats. He was not that good offensively speaking, and which is crazy given the fact that you have Jaylen Brown, Marcus Smart actually playing good, and Jason Tatum on the same damn team with Daniel Tice at the five who provides spacing. So when you're underperforming offensively, which is really the only thing we ask from you because we're not expecting you to be a great defender, it's really frustrating to watch you play. Now, Jaylen Brown, I don't even have anything bad to say about you. You brought your A game. You were averaging, 22 points per game this series, shooting 60% from the field and ridiculous from three. You did your thing. Cool. Now, Jason Tatum, look, man, I get it. You were phenomenal in game five. And in game four, you were phenomenal in that second half of the game. And looking at your numbers throughout the series, you averaged around 25, 10, and 5 off the top of my head. But when you go game by game, when you watch this whole series, I never felt as if you were actually the leader of this team. I always felt as if throughout these whole playoffs, Jaylen Brown was more of a leader. I felt as if Kemba was more of a leader. I felt as if Marcus Smart was more of a leader. And also with the timeliness of the shots, again, a lot of times, if you played good in the first half, in game four and in game five, you wouldn't have had to play as great as you did in the second half. You're supposed to be a future superstar. You were supposed to be the leader of this team. When I'm just keeping it real, you put up the numbers, but in terms of the timeliness of the shots, I just didn't feel it throughout the series, aside from the second half of game four and the second half of game five, if I'm being honest. If I'm being truly honest and if I'm keeping it a buck to what I saw when I watched the series. Now, Brad Stevens, I'm not gonna lie, bro. You were overrated. A couple years back, people thought that you really had the potential to be the heir to the throne to a Greg Popovich, right? The next best coach in the league. But if we're keeping it a bean, Nick Nurse is better than you. Yes, Nick Nurse is better than you. Eric Spoelstra is better than you. And there's honestly a decent amount of coaches in the league that are on your level. Like, we thought you were going to be head and above shoulders above everyone, but no, that's not the case. There's a lot of coaches in the league that are actually on your level. A lot of blame for the 2019 season strictly fell on Kyrie's shoulders. But I think one aspect of that team that just was just glossed over was Brad Stevens, because we just took for granted that he was just a good coach and Kyrie was just uncoachable. That was the narrative back then. But when we think about it now, was that really the case? Was that really the case? How much are we holding Brad Stevens for not being able to manage egos? How much are we going to hold Brad Stevens for not being able to manage a team with that many shot creators? We are holding Doc Rivers accountable right now. So why couldn't we do the same for Brad Stevens last year? It was just all on Kyrie. And I don't want to make this video about Kyrie, but that's what happened. Again, Brad Stevens has done a lot of good for this franchise, right? We probably wouldn't have made the 2016 playoffs without him. We probably wouldn't have been as good in 2017 and in 2018 without him. But maybe Brad Stevens is one of those coaches that you put in place to gain a culture, like Mark Jackson, what he did for the Golden State Warriors. Now, I don't think he should have gotten fired, but from Golden State's perspective, they thought that Mark Jackson was there to set the culture, to develop Steph, to develop Klay, to develop Draymond a little bit. So once he got to that level, they asked the question, can Mark Jackson actually lead us to a championship? And they answered, no. So the Celtics, that might be the same thing with Brad Stevens. Maybe he's just the Mark Jackson of this team. So now we ask, can Brad Stevens actually lead this team to a championship? And if the answer is no, since we have pieces that can actually win a championship, yes, we have to fire Brad Stevens. At least to me, I think we should fire Brad Stevens. Because if our goal is to win a championship and you have a coach that can't coach you to a championship, albeit being a good coach, then what are we doing? Then what are we doing? And my just this series alone, Eric Spoelstra outcoached the fuck out of you. He outcoached the fuck out of you. This man was running a zone. Now, for the people who don't know, the zone, the biggest weakness when it comes to the zone defense is good ball movement and shooting ability. Now, let me ask you this, right? What was the one thing everyone praised about the Celtics throughout the season? Shot creators. Kemba, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown, Gordon Hayward, and sometimes Marcus Smart. What else did people praise about the Boston Celtics this year? Shooting. Kemba Walker, Jaylen Brown, Jason Tatum, Gordon Hayward, and most of the time now, Marcus Smart. What else did people praise the Boston Celtics for? Defense. Defense. Yet this series, we couldn't guard Bam. We couldn't guard Tyler Hero. We couldn't guard Jimmy Butler wasn't even playing good. There's just... It's just, I'm frustrated. And I think it's just poetic that we lost a team with Jay Crowder, the guy who we traded for Kyrie. We lost a team with Kelly Olynyk. Again, a guy we let go because we wanted Kyrie. And we wanted to have space for Gordon Hayward. And we lost to a team with Jimmy Butler, a guy who we didn't want to trade Jason Tatum, not Jason Tatum, but those Brooklyn Nets for, because we thought we'd be better off with Gordon Hayward and those net picks, which I'm not even saying that's wrong, but I just find it ironic that we have Gordon Hayward and we have those Nets picks, and they reached their full potential, yet we still lost to a team led by Jimmy Butler. That's tough. That's going to be it for this tirade of a video. Shout out to the Miami Heat, Boston Celtics. I don't know. Harsh truth. This is what y'all wanted, right?